Hello and welcome to Nicola's Genetics Lessons. In this video I'm going to explain how by looking at the pedigree you can say the mode of inheritance. Assume that the individuals marked with asterisk do not carry any allele associated with the affected phenotype and that no other mutation spontaneously occurs. Also assume complete penetrance states the most likely mode of inheritance for this genetic disease. You can choose between autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, X-linked dominant, and X-linked recessive mode of inheritance. So let's assume that this is autosomal dominant genetic disorder, and for example, this person is affected, and his genotype can be capital A. I'm using red color for the defective allele, and this is dominant genetic disorder, so I'm using capital letter, and the other allele would be small a, and this is going to be genotype of this person, and this person would be phenotypically and genotypically normal, so his genotype would be small a, small a. And when we build a Punnett square, as you see, we can predict the progeny, the genotypes and phenotypes. So here we would have capital A and small a, capital A and small a here, and small a here, small a here. As you see, 50% in such a cross, 50% of the progeny would be affected. And the other 50% would be unaffected and would be genotypically and phenotypically normal. So that means that these three children have to belong to this genotype. So should have two normal alleles. So if this female would have two normal alleles, so small a, and this person here that is marked with asterisk, we know that he is genotypically normal, so also would have two normal alleles. So in such a cross, we wouldn't be able to see any affected children. So this cannot be autosomal dominant genetic disorder. So we can cross out this variant. So next variant would be autosomal recessive. Once again, if this is going to be autosomal recessive, this person here, his genotype have to be small a, in order for him to be affected with this genetic disorder. And if one of his alleles would be normal, when we have autosomal recessive genetic disorder, if here we would have capital A, his phenotype would be normal. So when we have autosomal recessive genetic disorder, both alleles have to be defective. So we also know that this person here has two normal alleles. So genotype would be capital A and capital A. And when we cross two people with these two genotypes, we can expect that 100% of their progeny would be phenotypically normal, but would be carriers. So we see that all their progeny are phenotypically normal. So let's take a look at the following generation. So we can assume that all the three children are heterozygous. They look normal, but would be carriers. So let's now consider this generation, second generation here. Actually, this is going to be a parental generation, first generation, and second generation. Some people may count that this is first generation, this is second, third, and fourth. It actually doesn't affect our calculations here. So we can assume that genotype of this person would be capital A and small a. and genotype of the person shown here with asterisk is normal or capital A and capital A. So genotype of the male would be capital A, and genotype of the female, we assume, would be capital A and small a. So once again, we built a Punnett square, and as you see, the genotypes, possible genotypes of the progeny would be as follows. So capital A and small a here, and capital A and small a here. Because this is autosomal recessive genetic disorder, we assume that this is autosomal recessive genetic disorder, 100% of such a cross would be phenotypically normal. But we see that one of the person here is affected. So we can say that this is not autosomal recessive genetic disorder. And we can cross out from our list. So we left with two variants, X-link dominant and X-link recessive. So let's assume that this is X-link dominant. So that means that genotype of this person have to be one defective X chromosome and one normal Y chromosome. And female here should be genotypically normal. So she would have two normal X chromosomes. And when we cross two genotypes, we can predict outcome of such a cross. So here we would have normal X chromosome, defective X chromosome, normal X chromosome and normal Y chromosome here, normal X chromosome from the mother side here, defective X chromosome from the father side, and normal X chromosome and Y chromosome from the father side, and X chromosome, as you see, from the mother side. So if this male would be affected with this genetic disorder, this is X-linked dominant, we assume, that means that 100% of his daughters would be affected with this genetic disorder, but none of his sons would be affected with this genetic disorder because they got Y chromosome from the father's side and X chromosome, any of these two normal X chromosome from the mother's side. So 100% of the male progeny in such a cross would be phenotypically and genotypically normal, but 100% of the females would be affected. So as you see, this female here is not affected, and we can say that this is not X-linked dominant genetic disorder. And the last variant left is X-linked recessive. So let's consider that this person here has a defective X chromosome, normal Y chromosome, and female here has two normal X chromosomes or two chromosomes with normal alleles on those chromosomes. And once again, the picture would be similar to the previous picture, but phenotypes would be different, because this time we consider that this is X-linked recessive genetic disorder. So as you see, 100% of the male progeny in such a cross would be genotypically and phenotypically normal, and 100% of the female progeny also would be normal. Those would be carriers, so they would have one defective allele, but because females has another normal X chromosome with normal allele on it, so phenotype of such females would be normal. So they are going to be heterozygous and going to be carriers. So let's put genotypes of the people whose genotype we can predict. So we know that genotype of this person here would be defective X chromosome and normal Y chromosome. And genotype of this female would be two normal X chromosomes. And females would be obligate carriers, so would have one defective X chromosome and one normal X chromosome. Defective X chromosome from the father side and normal X chromosome from mother side. And when she marries another male whose genotype is normal, we can predict outcome of such a cross if we build a Punnett square. So genotype of the male would be normal X and Y chromosome, and genotype of the female would be normal X chromosome and one defective X chromosome. So phenotype would be normal, but this female would be a carrier. And now we can see what would happen to the progeny. So here we would have two normal X chromosomes, normal X and Y chromosome here, and defective X chromosome here, and normal X chromosome here. Defective X chromosome here, and normal Y chromosome here. And as you see, 100% of the females would be phenotypically normal. Those 50% of females would be genotypically normal, and 50% would be carriers. But still, phenotype would be normal, just like the mother phenotype. And 50% of the male progeny would be phenotypically normal, but 50% of the male progeny would be affected. So we can say that genotype of this person here would be defective X chromosome and normal Y chromosome, and genotypes of other children would be male here would be, because his phenotype normal, the only variant for him would be normal X chromosome and Y chromosome, and female here can belong to any of these genotypes, no matter if she is going to be homozygous normal or heterozygous, she would be phenotypically normal. So we can say that her genotype would be normal X chromosome and blank space, because the second chromosome can be whether defective or normal, we don't know. So we just leave a blank space here. And also, can we say genotypes of the rest of the members of this family? So let's begin from the parental generation. Because male is normal, and we already know that this is X-link recessive genetic disorder, we can say that genotype of the male would be normal X chromosome and normal Y chromosome, but genotype of the female would be defective X chromosome and normal X chromosome. So genotype of the male here we also can predict, it's going to be normal X and Y chromosome, and genotypes of these females here would be, we can say only for sure for one X chromosome that this is going to be normal. We don't know about the second one. And as for the female here, because she has affected husband who is not related to her parents, so his genotype would be defective X chromosome and normal Y chromosome. And as you see, in this family we have affected male, but father cannot give a defective X chromosome to the male progeny. As you see, father only can give to his son's only Y chromosome. Then that means that mother is heterozygous, so has one defective X chromosome and one normal X chromosome. And this son got this defective X chromosome from the mother side, just like on this picture. So, genotype of this person would be defective X chromosome, normal Y chromosome, and female here would be homozygous for this genetic disorder. So she have to have two defective X chromosomes, and genotype of this male would be normal X chromosome and normal Y chromosome, and genotype of this female can be normal X chromosome. This X chromosome she got from her mother side, because from her father side she only can get one variant. Her father affected, so he has only one X chromosome, so he only can give defective X chromosome. But because phenotype of this female is normal, that means that she got from her mother normal X chromosome. And now we left two people here without genotypes, and we can say because these two males unaffected, the genotypes would be normal X, normal Y chromosome. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.